Hey guys, today I will show you how to add Zabbix Agent on your Windows machine and add it to hosts in your Zabbix. So first, go to your Windows machine. Usually you have to install the Zabbix Agent manually if you go to zabbix.com and go to download and then the agent. And then you have to type in all sort of commands in your command prompt. But I've created a PowerShell script that automates this whole process. And you can find it by going to github.com/twiggy. I will put a link in the description. Then go to repositories, Zabbix. And you can see here there's three files. You want to can download them or you can open it up. I will download them in a zip folder. Extract the folder. Close everything else down. So if you open the folder, you can see there's three files. We will concentrate on the installation file. I will just show you what everything in this file does. The first line here, it gets the host name of the server, pretty simple. We will have to use this later to manipulate the configuration file. The second one, it asks for the Zabbix server IP address or the proxy IP. It then creates a folder in the C drive of your Windows machine for all the Zabbix files. This command here downloads the agent directly from Zabbix. The 4.0.4, you can see that right here. Then it unzips the folder and moves it to the folder that it created earlier up here. Then it does some sorting of the files. It moves the files around. We will use that later when we install the service. And then it replaces the IP address within the configuration file that you typed in and replaces the host name in the configuration file. It then tries to install the service and start the service and then creates a firewall rule. So let's try and run this. So my IP address is 192.168.1.5. This is the IP address of my Zabbix server. Press enter. Yeah, that's it. That's everything you have to do to install the Zabbix agent. So if you go to your C drive and the Zabbix folder, you can now see there's a configuration file. Within this configuration file, we added the IP address of the Zabbix server. This one is for the passive checks. And this one is for the active checks and the host name. We have to use this for the active checks as well. So close the configuration file and inside services, open up services, search for Zabbix. You can see now it's running the Zabbix agent. And if we go to the firewall, advanced, then in inbound rules, you will be able to see there's an allow Zabbix communication. This is the firewall rule for the Zabbix agent. So that's all you have to do on your Windows machine. Then if you go into your Zabbix, and then go to configuration, hosts, you will have to add this Windows machine in here. So you go to create hosts. The host name has to be the host name of your Windows machine. You can find that under this PC and properties, change settings, change, and then copy this name. And then give it a visible name that could be Windows Server 2016, in my case. Give it a group. Mine is a virtual machine. And the agent interface has to be the IP address of your Windows machine. So if you do an IP config, you can see the IP address right here. Copy paste this, and the port will be the default port, and then add. And of course, before you start to get any items in, you have to link this to a template. I forgot that before. So if you go to hosts, find the Windows machine, templates, click on select, and I have a standard template for Windows. Select this, click on add, and then update. Then it should start to be green in a few seconds. So now you can see it has turned green. This means that it has now communicated with the Windows machine, and the Windows machine has communicated with the Zabbix server. So if you go into monitoring and latest data, you will now see that all the values are starting to come in. And yeah, that's how you install Zabbix Agent on your Windows machine. Bye.